I think it's also a tip for other people that are running courses, right? Wherever they are, whoever they're affiliated with. If you recognize a problem and you don't really do your maximum to address it, and you let that student progress or that diver progress, I mean, that's just kicking the can down the line, isn't it?
Sure.
That's saying, I've done my bit, they've done my...
Somebody else can look after that.
Yeah. But then you end up in a scenario where you'll have a diver that, let's say, they've got 300, 500, however many dives, they'll have a collection of nice certifications.
Yeah.
But they've missed some really interesting stuff very early on.
So I wonder, why do instructors kick the can? Why do they give it somebody else? Is it because they really can't be bothered doing it, but they're capable? Or is it because they can't do it? They're not capable of doing something that we know they should, right? Well,
I think it might be a third answer as well, which is maybe they haven't recognized the value of it, the point of it. Maybe they don't dive that well themselves. Maybe it's normal for that circle of divers that they're in.
Sure.
This is how everybody dives, therefore it's okay. You know, we're not going to change that. I mean, we've seen that when we've gone to certain places and we look different to other people and, you know, oh, you don't need to be in trim for this location. Your buoyancy doesn't need to be that good because it's all rocks and stones and, you know, why bother?
Sure.
You know, I think that is something which I hear more and more. And so, you know, okay, yes, there are time pressures for some courses. The way that they're run, the dive centers that maybe they're run through, everyone has business pressures. But of course, you know, you've got to make the distinction between, you know, what do you want to be involved in? If I simply want to tick boxes, read off a plastic slate with skills I'm going to do on dive two or dive three, that is a different style of training. And that is something that we've all done, but it's something which, you know, I don't believe in. And I don't want to be part of anymore.
Yeah.
And yes, it's true that, you know, somebody will come, you're expecting to run course A, course B, but you've detected a problem and it's not just going to stop you from delivering what you set out to do. You know, you can't knowingly send that person any further. I actually can't bring myself to do it anymore.
Sure.
You need to have a difficult conversation.
I'm going to say, because the other thing is, because we do set the bar where we set it as high as we can, we could never do that. So when we accept a course, we know what we're in for, right?
Cool. Yep.
And once day one comes, we have a very good indication of what work we're going to have to put in.
Yeah, yeah.
And we're not lazy either. We don't want an easy ride.
No.
And, a lot of the time, what we want is, I like it because you know after day one, you know what satisfaction that customer's likely to get.
Mm-hmm.
So once you do put that work in, once you do go that extra mile for them, you know that it's going to change the way they dive. I mean, what they're able to do in the future. And not only that, it doesn't just change them. It usually changes the buddies they're with and probably affects a lot of divers, you know, in their circle.
Well,
right?
I mean, that's one of the lessons. I mean, so, you know, we've both done instructor training for our different agencies. You know, we've had to teach different programs. And when you see what they might value as an important part of instructor development and instructor training, and what I now see and what you now see, you know, I don't want to deliver courses that have anything to do, you know, with these fixed structures, with these minimum requirements. And it becomes very much more that the reason that you're doing the teaching has nothing to do with getting a certification, getting extra credits on your account, getting, you know, silver badge, green badge, whatever that is. It's much more to do with saying, well, you know, I love diving. You know, I mean, it's the thing that I do. It's the thing that I love most in life. And, you know, why are you involved in it if you don't want to share that love, share that passion, and have people, you know, respect the place that they're in, understand the risks of the sport that they're undertaking, and just do your best for them?
Yeah.
Because I think that if you're not doing that, I don't want it just to be, you know, a day-to-day job, a 9-to-5, sat at a desk, here's the next person, here's the next course. You know, there's a missing part to that.
Sure. And I don't think a lot of students want that either.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think if you actually got somebody who's never dived before, asked them, or given that scenario you just said, they're going to choose the latter of the instructors. They're going to want the one who really wants to do a good job.
Mm-hmm.
Because ultimately for them, You know, yes, they want to enjoy being underwater, but if that, if they ever thought that safety or their enjoyment was at risk, which a lot of the times it is, they're going to always choose the better of the instructors. I mean, and again, for me, a lot of the reasons to even create these materials is just to raise the bar, really. You know, we can only ever be so busy.
And I
think you're incredibly busy, right? You don't have a day off for, well, you have some days off that you've mandatory put in, but the courses you're running, you've got no availability for quite some time, right? And that's simply because we're doing a good job. People want that. There's always going to be customers out there who want the good job. So actually cutting prices, doing less, isn't going to help anybody, actually. Ultimately, it's going to probably stop that diver diving due to them not having the comfort level they should get or they would have got with somebody who was prepared to put the time in. So for me, I just want to see everything, the bar get raised, and the people who are putting the work in, well, they're going to get the work.